Watermelon doesn't stand a chance. This is the switch of power right here, man. I switched this thing, that watermelon's gone.
Whatever you do today, don't blink. Today's episode is about teleportation. Or what I like to call high-speed travel. Now, if you don't want to trust your eyes, that's okay, because I have special guests, Colinsky and Devan Key from YouTube, coming on the show, and we're going to use this vacuum pump, the air around us, and a little bit of air pressure to get a ball moving so fast, you won't want to believe your eyes. Welcome to Impossible Science. Hey everyone, it's Jason Latimer, world champion of magic, coming to you with another Impossible Science. Now today's topic is teleportation, or high-speed travel. And even though we haven't been able to create teleportation through science just yet, that doesn't mean we can't get a ball moving so fast you can't even see it. So today, I thought it'd be really fun to talk about
a vacuum.
A vacuum, it's a space that has no matter or air molecules in it, like space. Or think of any container in your house. If you open it up, even though there's nothing in there, there's air molecules still in there. Even if I cap it, there's air molecules still in there. The only way to get them out is to use a vacuum pump, make sure it's perfectly sealed, and suck the air molecules out of there. So instead of building a vacuum chamber out of a bell jar, I'm gonna build a vacuum chamber out of this 8-foot PVC pipe.
We're here with Colinsky and Devan Key.
What's up?
If you guys haven't seen their experiments on YouTube, you gotta check them out. It's just amazing
Not
stuff.
Quite as scientific as his, but they can get a little bit crazy as well.
Well, this is vacuum/cannon.
What? Which, that's not, like, we have vacuums at home, but ours do not actually blast ping pong balls at a high velocity.
I can't wait for this. If everything goes correctly, if this ping pong ball will vanish from one side and appear in another.
Oh! What?
Go ahead, we're gonna load up the cannon.
So everybody gets to do it?
Yeah.
All right. Okay, cool. So we're gonna place ping pong ball in here like that.
Right, we're gonna push it down so that we can see it. Now what I'm doing here is we're gonna put a piece of Mylar on the side. And now I've capped both sides of this PVC pipe with Mylar.
Yep.
And what we're gonna do is I'm gonna screw this on so we get this nice and as close to airtight as possible.
Exactly, yes.
All right, so what's gonna happen is the faster you go, the more Mother Nature tries to prevent you from going that fast.
Yep.
By putting her hand on your forehead. And air resistance, right? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna suck all the air out of this. What you don't notice is that there's all this air above us pushing down on us right now. So when we pop that side, all this air is gonna rush in through here and launch it out that side.
Okay.
If everything goes as planned. All right,
so sounds good.
Let's vacuum the air out.
All right.
So you can see the indention here. Why don't you check it out? There's an indention. That's the suction that's going on.
Whoa.
It's happening on both sides, all right?
Yep.
Let's turn off the vacuum. Disconnect it here. All right, so this is a vacuum chamber. All you have to do is pop that.
Is it gonna be loud?
Yeah. Yeah, you just have to, your job is to watch the ball go from that end to that end. Okay. Ready?
All right, you ready? Three.
One, two, three.
Jeez!
Whoa, dude!
Without knowing the drag, friction, or how effective our vacuum cannon was, it's possible that the ping pong ball went supersonic.
That was one of the coolest sounds ever, by the way. You should like sound like a sound effect.
Like did you see it go?
Yeah. I saw it like here, and I saw it as end over there.
I figure, why don't we weight the ball? Then it would go a lot slower, but then it has more mass, and it could
maybe explode a watermelon?
Maybe explode a watermelon.
Yeah,
right,
let's do it.
I decided to add some air pressure behind it.
Yes.
So we've got a canister of CO2, then we're gonna add 100 PSI behind it, and then we're gonna take the air out of here, and we're gonna attack the watermelon.
Love it. All watermelon doesn't stand a chance. This is the switch of power right here, man. I switched this thing, that watermelon's gone.
Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Oh! Holy cow! Dude, nicely done. Oh my gosh! Literally blew the water.
One for science.
Pieces. Wow. Holy cow! Look at that.
Thank you. I knew that would work.
Yeah.
What we don't notice is that all around us are air molecules. They're outside and even inside this clear tube. When we placed a ping pong ball inside the tube and capped both sides with a thin membrane, we used a vacuum pump to remove the air molecules inside this chamber, creating a vacuum. And although there was very few air molecules inside this chamber, there was still all of our atmosphere outside of the chamber. So as soon as we punctured the membrane on one side, our atmosphere rushed into this pipe, picking up the ping pong ball as it surfed on a shockwave of air molecules rushing in, sending our ping pong ball faster than we could see out the other side. Teleportation? No. How about just high-speed science? Well, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed my goofy experiment of high-speed travel and making a ping pong ball literally obliterate a watermelon. And until next time, stay curious, because the right question changes everything. We're gonna go launch a ping pong ball faster than the blink of an eye. See?